Hey, what's up guys, it's Tekosaur and I hope you are all doing well. So after getting some requests asking how to increase TDP beyond the default maximum of 30 watt on the Legion Go, today I'm bringing you this video guide that will explain everything about this modification as well as including performance difference in multiple scenarios for you to understand the real performance gain possible. It's worth mentioning that based on my personal experience, there is some associated risk with increasing TDP so high. Therefore, we'll go over that as well. I quite recommend you to watch the entirety of this video guide before applying any change as it packs various methods and the troubleshooting. And at the end, I'm going to give you my recommended settings. So without extending the intro any further, let's dive right in. The first step we'll need to do is installing Smokeless USB bootable BIOS tool. Download it from its GitHub project, and for this guide, I'll be using the beta version. And I recommend you to do so for the reason that it was updated more recently than the stable version from 2 years ago, ensuring better compatibility for a newer chip. The next step is extracting the files to your USB drive and make sure its file format is FAT32. Also, it's crucial to have a keyboard connected to navigate in the tool, as the Legion Go controllers won't work there, neither will do the touch screen. Optionally, you can use a mouse as well. Alright, now as the Legion Go is booting, press the volume up button to access the Legion BIOS. Set the connected USB drive as the top boot priority and go to more settings. Here I'd like to mention that I'm using the latest BIOS version as of this date. Now go to configuration and make sure that the thermal policy used is STAPM instead of STT. If you are not familiar with the difference between them, check out my other recommended video here where I explained the difference and did some performance comparison. So briefly for this tweak, it's crucial to set thermal policy to STAPM in order to allow the chip to boost. Then go to security and disable secure boot. Finally, save the changes and reboot. Now it should take us to the Smokeless tool menu. As you can see, the screen is set to the default portrait orientation. Therefore, I'll just rotate it 90 degrees so you can see better. Alright, now navigate in the following way. Device Manager, AMD CBS, SMU Common Options, and here we can find all the system power settings. The first change we'll make is setting the system configuration from 30 watt to 54 watt. Then change the SPL control from auto to manual. And digit 5 with 4 zeros as the value set here is in megawatt. Also change PTT control from auto to manual and input 50,000 for all three of fast, slow, and slow PTT time constant. Finally, press escape and it will ask you to confirm changes. So hit the Y button on keyboard and press continue for changes to take effect. Now as it's booting, press the Legion volume up button and revert the boot priority back to Windows and enable secure boot back again. Save the changes and now we are back to Windows. Now even though we changed power settings in BIOS, however we'll still need to match them in OS as well. So for that, I'll be showing you three different ways on how to do it. But before installing any software or tinkering in Windows, make sure to create a restore point should you mess up something or if you would like to return everything back to default with just one click. So in the start menu, search for create a restore point, press configure and enable system protection. And then hit the create button. Name the restore point to whatever name you would like. And alright, with it created, now at least we have a point back should anything go wrong. Now for the first approach on setting TDP in OS, first we have Handheld Companion, you can find it on GitHub. And here we are, in the device section, set the maximum power limit to 50 watt. Now in performance section, we create a profile and slide the TDP slider to 50 watt. But also make sure to have CPU boost mode set to aggressive or anything except for disabled. Also set power mode to performance. Here at the bottom we can also see some notifications where Zab is telling us that the core isolation is turned on. Therefore, TDP changes may not be available, so make sure to disable core isolation by clicking here. And don't forget to do a system restart upon that. You can also choose to disable Legion Space services, which for instance will prevent the Legion Space quick menu from being opened or the changing controller options. But still, Handheld Companion provides you some options such as controlling the fan, and there's also a quick menu to control some options. For me personally, I would rather prefer to have Legion Space at all times in order to have all features intact. And we'll see later on that it's not a necessary step after all. Now onto the second approach we have, which is by using Auto TDP tool by the folks. A big shout out for this awesome tool. You can download it from the Discord server linked in his video here. It's worth mentioning that before you run it for the first time, Windows will give you this warning saying protection preventing it from running. So just brace more info and run anyway to get in. Here's a nice thing that it can show us the TDP set in BIOS, which is 50 watt, while in OS currently it's 32 watt. So our task is matching the two of them. To change OS TDP, in the main menu, brace 1 and digit 50. Values here instead are in watt. You can see it says successively set step EM, fast, slow and APU slow limit. Now if we reopen it, we can see 50 watt on both OS and BIOS just fine. Other optional settings you can apply here by going to settings, pressing the S button. Toggle turbo mode to aggressive, and as you can see here it says that all modes will do the same effect except for disabled. So it won't matter much whether it's aggressive or efficient aggressive, etc. Now go back and go to the miscellaneous menu by pressing the R button. Here it says core isolation is enabled. Again disable it here too, like we did previously on Handheld companion app. Remember a reboot is required for this to take effect. Now back in the main menu, press the W button to set it to performance mode. And press V to access this menu where we can change temperature limit and APP settings. First press 3 to set the performance cap on temperature. Make sure it's set to 100 degrees Celsius. Go back and then go to APP options, here we'll set it to 0%, which means maximum clock. By default it's set to 50%, balancing between power saving and performance. For us to have the highest clocks, we'll prioritize the highest performance setting naturally. With all that done, as you can see it has been successfully set to 50 watt. As nice as it looks, however as few minutes pass in of me playing Cyberpunk 2077, something pretty serious happened. The whole Legion Go will shut down completely, and it happened also multiple times. I'm not entirely sure of the exact reason, but probably it could be due to the VRM reaching high temperature or not being able to feed it with lots of power over time. Or maybe some other components are overheating, not necessarily the APU, and it's all acting as self-protection mechanism to shut down. And of course this all happened even with the fan at full speed with an ambient temperature of around 23 degrees Celsius. So it kind of gave me concerns about the safety of setting it on 50 watt TDP. Anyway, for my Legion Go safety, I had to lower my standards just a bit. But again, another issue arise. This time it's not turning off anymore, but after a few minutes of gameplay, TDP is going back to the default 30 watt, making our whole 2 week short term and pretty failing. And even disabling Legion Space didn't fix that issue. It was still switching TDP back to 30 watt after a few minutes. So after experimenting, I found the definite settings that will keep the Legion Go TDP steady no matter how much time goes on. So allow me to show you how. Let's go back to the Smokeless tool. Instead of 50 watt, I'll be setting it on 45 watt. Thankfully, it never gave me any shutdowns in this case. So on mine, I'll set the system configuration to 45 watt, as well as sustained power limit and BBT settings. The new addition, however, is that this time I changed the step EM control from auto to manual and set system temperature tracking to zero, which means disabled, and both step EM boost override and step EM boost to one to make sure it's activated at all times. Another major change I believe that made the difference in keeping TDP steady is setting T-scan time constant in seconds to this peak number, which is almost infinite. I believe in this way we are giving it the maximum time to keep step EM boost on. I've also changed the TJ max to 105, you can optionally set it to 100 or even auto. Finally, the last change I did in Smokeless tool found in the smart shift control. Here I've set smart shift from auto to manual and set it to enabled. I've also set APU SPBT limit to 45 watt along with sustained power limit, fast and slow PPT limit in order to match it with the previous configurations we have done before. Alright, we are done in Smokeless tool, let's save our changes. Now back to Windows, the last approach I wanted to go with in changing OS TDP is by using the Ryzen Universal tool. I quite love this tool for its rich features and reliability. Also with this setup, I kept all Legion Space services on. Everything I had to do here is creating a new power profile, setting APU temperature and scan boost to maximum, which is why earlier in Smokeless tool, I've set TG max on 105 degrees in order to match it with this one. As for APU step EM limit, I've set it to 45 watt, as well as slow and fast power limits. Now the reason I didn't enable the slow and fast boost duration is because here the maximum limit is 1024 seconds, while in BIOS we were able to set it to much bigger number. So I wanted to avoid always overwriting what we have defined in BIOS. Finally, once you make changes, don't forget to save your profile and apply it like so. Alright, so once applying all, by checking in Auto TDP tool, we can see that TDP in BIOS is set as 45 watt as well as in BIOS. So we are good to go. And to show you a proof that it's actually remaining at 45 watt, here is a hyperlapse recording of Cyberpunk 2077 gameplay. I've left it running for over an hour and it stayed in the same way. So hopefully we can call it a successful modification this time. Let's get over now to some benchmarks. Now, even though it was somehow dangerous to set it to 50 watt because of high temperature concern and damage, I've still managed to run some benchmarks in order to show you guys the difference it can make. Starting with Cinebench R23, we got a maximum uplift of about 1700 points in the multi-core score at 50 watt. Still, already with 35 watt, we got a 700 point increase, which is a pretty sweet uplift given the ever so slight increase we have done. Another thing I noticed is that at 50 watt, we got about the same score as 45 watt. The reason for that is because, as you can see here, right at the first test loop, score was quite high, reaching almost the one achievable by Threadripper CPU of 16,000. But as the test loop goes on, I believe due to high temperature, it's throttling down performance, giving a similar score to 45 watt. Still, this makes me quite proud of what the Z1 Extreme performance can actually get to. It's a pretty capable piece of hardware. Anyway, as we check temperatures, for CPU we got a maximum of 75 degrees on 30 watt, 83 on 35 watt, 92 on 40 watt, 96 on 45 watt, and finally a whopping maximum 100 degrees on 50 watt. GPU temperature also scaled up as we increased maximum TDP, reaching up to 78 in the case of 50 watt. Now as for the SSD, it got up to 68 degrees Celsius. On to the second test we have, which is 3D Mark TimeSpy benchmark. We also see a good uplift in the CPU score, mostly reaching 9293 score for the 50 watt setup, so about 700 point increase in the CPU. But again, even increasing it to 35 watt gave us already a 300 point increase, which is about half of what the 50 watt gave us in performance gains. Still, something really surprised me: at 30 watt, the total final score is classified as excellent, but with 50 setup, it got to the legendary class baby, being less than 100 points away from the highest score ever recorded on this chip, which is quite marvelous if you ask me. And I'm not even using the other tweaks done in my other videos, such as the memory timing one. But I also got surprised by how ETA Prime YouTuber got his Legion go to 60 watt and still had lower 3D Mark TimeSpy score than my 50 watt setup. Anyway, as for temperatures, this time for CPU, it reached maximum of 73 in 30 watt, 80 in 35 watt, 85 in 40 watt, 92 in 45 watt, and it hit 97 in 50 watt. As for GPU, it got up to 85 for 50 watt. Finally, for SSD, it got up to 66. And finally, we are doing a Cyberpunk benchmark. It's clear we didn't get much difference for the final score, just around 150. And this time, the winner is actually the 45 watt setup, getting highest FPS result. Now, one could wonder why it's not the 50 watt, perhaps due to thermal throttling or something, I'm not quite entirely sure. So anyway, if we compare from 30 to 45 watt, we got a 3 FPS increase in average, but also improved in the low FPS. And looking at frame pacing, we also see a small improvement on 45 watt compared to 30 watt. So now that you have seen the performance difference in all those 3 tests, do you think it's actually worth it after all? And based on results, which limit do you think other than 30 watt could possibly be your choice? I'm always curious to know your opinion, so feel free to drop it in the comment section. And to conclude this video, I would say that changing the TDP on the Legion Go isn't so straightforward and should be done right in order to avoid high temperature damaging hardware components over time. My personal and final advice is to always make sure to monitor temps closely first as you make TDP changes above the default one, in order to ensure maximum performance and longevity. In my opinion, 35 watt is already a sweet uplift if you are looking to be close to the original maximum TDP while also keeping temperatures and power consumption at bay. I also need to mention that even though we have changed TDP in the Smokeless tool to 45 watt, we can still control it below that by using the Ryzen utility tool in OS, giving you versatile option depending on scenario. Another important thing to note 45 watt was the best I could get without the Legion Go shutdown, but I can't be sure if it's going to be the case for everyone. For some it may be at 40 or even 50 watt could run fine. There are many variables here, such as ambient temperature and fan speed, or perhaps you have a modded back cover allowing better airflow. For example, in my test, I was using the original back cover. Nevertheless, as a general rule, always proceed understanding what goes well for your unit. Still, if you got any question, please let me know in the comment section, and you can also connect with me over at TechoSword Discord server for discussion and troubleshooting. At the end, I really hope this guide was useful. If it was the case, kindly give it a like and subscribe to TechoSword to be updated on future videos. Also consider becoming a member and supporter of TechoSword to have early access on videos, exclusive benchmarks and findings, future video spools, and much more. Thanks for watching and support, and see you in the next one.